Hello and welcome back, dear students. Wish you all stay happy, healthy and safe at home and do your studies regularly and properly. I'm Yojana Parak and today we are going to start a new chapter for Standard 3 students from your English grammar textbook. The name of this chapter is The Sentences. Now, how the sentences are formed and what does it mean by a sentence? So, sentence is nothing but just group of words, but this group of words should be arranged in a proper sequence and it should make a meaning. It should have a sensible meaning. If the group of words are arranged in a proper sequence and if it makes any sense, then those group of words are known as sentence. Okay? Now, what does a sentence contain? A sentence contains all parts of speech, that is subject, verb, helping verb, object, then preposition, conjunction, adjectives, interjections, and adverbs. So, all these parts of speech are included in a sentence, but they are arranged in a proper sequence. If it is so, then it would be called as a complete, meaningful, sensible sentence. Okay? Now, there are few types of sentences. So, that we are going to see one by one. First, let us try to understand that how the sentence is formed with few examples. Here, the first example you can see, this river flows through Allahabad. Then next one is, the flowers in the garden look beautiful. Here, this words, this group of words make a sense that यहाँ पे जो river है ये इलाहाबाद से flow करती है. तो ये एक clear meaning दे रहा है कि river कहाँ से flow कर रही है उसके बारे में बताया है. And next sentence, the flower in the garden look beautiful. So ये भी sentence meaningful है कि यहाँ पर flowers की beauty के बारे में बताया है. That makes sense. If it is so that the words are arranged like this, that makes sense, then only it would be called as a sentence. Keep in mind that every sentence should begin with capital letter, and if proper noun is given in that sentence, then that first letter of proper noun should be written in capital letter. At the end of the sentence, there should be punctuation. In punctuation, there can be full stop, question mark or exclamation mark, and that would vary according to the type of sentence that we are going to see further. Let us see few more examples of sentences. Here the first example is, the sun is indeed a star. So here it tells you about the sun, that the sun is actually a star. Here again, the first letter is capital, at the end of the sentence full stop is kept, and the sun is a natural thing and is the only one thing in universe that is proper noun. So S is capital. Next is, Sonali is reading a book. Here also, first thing, that Sonali is a proper noun, that is why S is capital, and second thing, because the sentence begin with the word Sonali, for that also S is capital, and at the end of the sentence full stop is kept. And Sonali is reading a book, that tells you about the activity of Sonali and that makes sense. That is why it is a complete sentence. So these sentences tell us that something is true. The sun is being a star, or Sonali reading a book. Both these sentences are statements. A statements always begin with a capital letter and end with full stop. This kind of sentences which tells you about statement, or which are telling you about the truth. So this kind of sentences are known as declarative sentences or assertive sentences. Now in assertive sentences, there can be two types, positive and negative, that can be called as affirmative and negative. So affirmative sentences are positive and negative sentence will be negative. Here, if the second example, which is Sonali is reading a book, that is affirmative assertive sentence, that is positive declarative sentence. Instead of this, if I add not after is, after the helping verb, if I add not, it will become negative declarative sentence. And the sentence will be, Sonali is not reading a book. So in this way, negative declarative sentence can be made. Just after adding not after the helping verb. Now read these sentences. When did you get up in the morning? What are you buying me for my birthday? Here in these sentences, you can notice question mark is kept at the end of the sentence. So the sentences or group of words which end with the question mark, the punctuation which is kept there, that is question mark. So, if it ends with the question mark, that means it is a question. And if it is a question, that means it is an interrogative sentence. It is an interrogative sentence. Okay. Now, here, first exercise has been given to you. And you have to identify whether the group of words make any sense, whether the group of words are sentence or not. So let us try to find out. First one, a dancer. Does it tell you anything about dancer? No. So it is not a sentence. For that you have to write NS. Next is, Meenakshi is taking dance classes these days. Yes, it tells you about the activity of Meenakshi. So it is a sentence. So you have to write S. Then, how did you solve these sums? Here again, this is a question and it makes a complete sense that here it is being asked about the method of solving the sums. So it makes sense, that means it is a complete sentence. For that you have to write capital S. Next is, thirsty. Does it tell you anything about thirsty? Only one word is given, so that cannot be a sentence. So this is not a sentence. For that you have to write NS. Next is, we want to go to where? It is said that they want to go, but where? The sentence is not complete, so it is not a sentence. Keep in mind that the group of words should make a complete sense. Next is, my sister spilled milk on the dining table. So here it makes sense that who did the action? My sister. What she did? She spilled. What she spilled? Milk. Where she spilled the milk? On the dining table. So, all the things which were required are mentioned here in a proper sequence that makes sense and the sentence is complete. So, we will call it a sentence. For that, we will put S. Next is, the hockey match was. The hockey match was? Don't know. So, it does not tell you anything about the hockey match. So, it is meaningless sentence, or you can say meaningless group of words. So, here you will write not a sentence. For that you will write NS. Next is, what is your name? It is clear that someone is asking about your name. So, this is a clear meaningful question. So, this is a sentence. For that you will write S. In this way, you have to find out whether the group of words make any sense or not, and whether they are complete sentences or not. Now, again, another exercise is given to you. Here, take the sentences that are questions and cross out the ones that are statement. Okay, you have to identify which one is question and which one is not. For identifying the question, first thing, that at the end there should be question mark, and second thing, that the statement should begin with helping verb or should begin with WH question words. So for identifying the interrogative sentence or question sentence, you have to look whether the helping verb is kept after the subject or whether the helping verb is kept before the subject. If the helping verb is after the subject, then it is statement. If the helping verb is before the subject, that means it is a question. And at the end of the question, there should be a question mark. Now, let's start this exercise. First one is, who drops you off at school. So here, this is a question about a person who drops you off at school. So it begins with WH question and then question mark is kept. So it is a question. Now, what are WH words? It contains who, that means kaun, what, that means kya, which, yani kaun sa, why, yani kyun, how, yani kaise, where, yani kahan, when, yani kab. So this kind of question words will be used to make interrogative sentence. So if you see this kind of words, you will understand that this is a question. Next is I am. Here you can notice that am is your helping verb and that is used after the subject. I is your subject and am is your helping verb. And the helping verb is used after the subject at the end of the sentence, that is full stop. So it is clearly a statement. So you have to put wrong for that. Next is did you remember? Here did is your helping verb and you is your subject. So did, the helping verb has been placed before the subject, that means it is a question, and at the end of the sentence there is question mark also, so it is clearly a question. You have to put right there. Next is do you. Again, here you can notice that do is your helping verb and you is that is your subject, and helping verb is kept before the subject. At the end of the sentence there is question mark, so clearly it is a question. So you have to put right there. Next is these leaves have turned yellow. So here have is your helping verb which is used after the subject, after leaves. So this is a statement, at the end of the sentence there is full stop. So you have to put wrong for that. Next is I am watching my favorite TV show now. Again, I is your subject, am is your helping verb, and helping verb is placed after the subject at the end of the sentence, there is full stop. So it is clearly a statement and you have to put wrong for that. Next is where are you going? Here where is your question word, and you is your helping verb, you is your subject and are is your helping verb, and the helping verb is placed before the subject. So first thing you notice that where, that is your question word. Second thing, that helping verb is before the subject. Third thing, that at the end of the sentence there is question mark, so it is clearly an interrogative sentence. So it is a question, you have to put right there. Next is I could not sleep well last night. At the end of the sentence there is full stop. Second thing, I, that is your subject, has been placed first, and could, which is your auxiliary verb, that is placed after the subject. So it is statement, you have to put cross there. So in this way you have to identify which one is question and which one is the statement. Now let's move to the next exercise, that is rewrite the sentences using capital letters, full stop and question marks wherever required. Okay, so here you have to put capital letter, full stop and question mark in this sentences. First of all, for that you have to identify whether the sentence is statement or question. So according to that type of sentence you have to put the punctuation. Let's begin with the first question. Every actor in the play was great. Here, as I told you, that every statement begins with the capital letter. So first letter will be capital, E will be capital. After that, every actor in the play was great. At the end of the sentence, you have to put full stop. Next is, which cinema hall are we going to? Which, that is your question word. So clearly it is a question. Again, first letter will be capital and at the end of the sentence, you have to put question mark. Next is, we should give way to the ambulance behind us. Here, we is your subject and should, that is your modal auxiliary verb. So, that auxiliary verb is placed after the subject. Clearly, it is statement. And here, first letter should be capital. At the end of the sentence, there should be full stop. Next is, have you seen my umbrella anywhere? Here, have, that is your helping verb or auxiliary verb, and that is placed before the subject. You is your subject and helping verb is placed before the subject. So that is clearly a question. At the end of the sentence, you have to put question mark, and the sentence should begin with capital letter. Next is, Kanika is a kind-hearted girl. Here, the sentence begins with the proper noun. And again, as I told you, that every sentence at the beginning that should have capital letter. So, because of proper noun also and because of the beginning letter, the first letter will be capital. In Kanika, K will be capital, and then is a kind-hearted girl. At the end of the sentence, there will be full stop, because Kanika is your subject and is, that is your auxiliary verb, and auxiliary verb is kept after the subject, that means it is a statement. Next is, this restaurant serves only vegetarian food. Here, this restaurant, that is your subject, and serves, that is your verb. So here subject is at the first position. So clearly it is a statement. First letter will be capital, and at the end of the sentence you have to put full stop. Next is, are these old photographs of your father? Here are is your helping verb, and that is placed before the subject, that means it is a question. If helping verb is before the subject, clearly it is a question. At the end of the sentence, you have to put question mark, and the sentence should begin with the capital letter. Next is, she plays the piano really well. She is your subject, that is at the first place. Clearly, it is a statement. At the end of the sentence, you have to put full stop, and the sentence should begin with the capital letter. So here again, this exercise completes. Now, let's move to the next chapter, which is related to it. That is asking questions. Now here we are going to study about the interrogative sentence, about questions in detail. So first thing, what are questions? When some information is asked, that is called a question. And how can the information be asked? So few words which are used to ask the information, that are known as question words. And if you see these question words at the beginning of the sentence, that means it is a question, or you can say it is an interrogative sentence. Let's see this one by one. Who is coming over the dinner? Kaun aa raha hai dinner par? So yahan par us person ke baare mein pucha ja raha hai, about the subject they are asking. So who is asking about the person? That is asking about the information of person. So clearly it is a question, and at the end of the sentence, question mark will be kept. Next is, whose party are you attending today? Again here, the party belongs to whom? That information is asked. So as this is, as in this sentence, question is asked, so it is a question and it is an interrogative sentence. At the end of the sentence, question mark is kept. Next is, what have you bought for her? So यहाँ पर पूछा जा रहा है कि आपने उसके लिए क्या खरीदा है. It is being asked about the thing. So यहाँ पर उस thing की information पूछी जा रही है. And whenever information is asked, that is clearly a question. At the end of the sentence, there will be question mark. Next is, when are you leaving? The time of leaving is asked. So here the information about the time is asked. Clearly, it is a question. At the end of the sentence, there will be question mark, and the sentence will begin with the capital letter. And this kind of question words are placed at the first place in the sentence. Next is, where is this museum you are talking about? Here, the place of that museum is asked. So, information about the place is asked when you ask where. Clearly, it is a question, and W will be capital because it is the first letter, and the sentence will end with the question mark. Next is, why are you crying? The reason is being asked by asking why. So W will be capital, and at the end of the sentence there will be question mark. Next, which of these storybooks do you want? Here few options are given, and one of the option is about to be selected. And it is being asked about which option would you like. So here, which, that is your question word, and that will begin with capital letter. At the end of the sentence, there will be question mark. Next is, how did you hurt yourself? Here, the method is asked or the process is asked by asking how. So, H will be capital and at the end of the sentence, there will be question mark. Now, we will see about this question words in detail. First one is who and whose. Both of these are used to ask about people. For example, here you can see who is the new girl and whose pencils are this. But the difference is who mein directly person ke baare mein pucha jata hai and whose mein ye pucha jata hai ki jo bhi particular thing hai wo kisse belong karti hai, yani importance thing ka hai aur wo kisse belong karti hai ye pucha ja raha hai, direct person ke baare mein nahi pucha ja raha. Although the question is about the person, but who mein directly focus person par hai and whose mein जो ऑब्जेक्ट है वो किससे बिलोंग कर रहा है ये पूछा जा रहा है. नेक्स्ट इज व्हाट यूजुअली आस्क्स अबाउट थिंग्स. ओके, इन द आंसर ऑफ व्हाट यूजुअली द यूजुअली एनी थिंग विल बी रिटन. सो व्हाट इज आस्क अबाउट थिंग्स और ऑब्जेक्ट्स. व्हाट गिफ्ट्स डिड यू गेट ऑन योर बर्थडे. Next is when, that is used to ask about the time when the action occurred. For example, when do you plan to join the karate classes? Next is where, it is used to ask about places. For example, where will you park your car? So where is used to know the information of the place. Next is why, that is used to ask about reason. For example, why is she standing here? So here, why is she standing here? The reason is asked. Next, which asks about a specific choice from a limited number of options. So in which options will be given to you and you will be asked among the option which one you choose. So which is used to ask about your choice among the options. For example, which way did the car turn? Next is how is asked about the way of something which gets done, or you can say about the method, that how, or about the process, that how the action was done. Okay, let's see the example. How does this machine work? So here it is asked about the work of that machine, the method, that how this machine works. Next is how are you doing. So in this it is asked about someone's feeling. How is used to ask about the process, method, or the way in which something gets done, or about someone's feeling. Now, these were the question words, but if you want to form a question, you can also use am, is, are, was, were, has, have, had, do, does, did, this kind of auxiliary verbs. Other than the question words, using these auxiliary verbs also, the question sentence can be made. For example, are you going to the market and does she play badminton? So in this sentences, just the helping verb has been kept before the subject, and then you can make it interrogative sentence or make it a question. At the end of the sentence, you have to put question mark. Now let's try to evaluate what we have learned with this exercise. Here first exercise is given that you have to match this questions with the question words and you have to complete the question. First is where, so place is being asked, so that will match with where are you going. Next is what, so here what is asked about thing. Let's see in which question it is asked about thing. What time does the library close? So here in what, the time of the closing of library that is asked. Next is how. So in how, the process, method, or the way of doing something that will be asked. So how do you use a laptop? Tell me the way. Next is why. In why, the reason will be asked. Here you can see, why have you worn a white shirt today? So what is worn, that we know. When it is worn, that we know. But why it is done, that we don't know. So why would be the correct question for this sentence. Next is when. So when is used to ask about the time. So that will match with when will your exams be over. The time when the exam will over, that is asked. Next is whose. After whose, object will be given for certain, because the focus is on object and it is asked that this particular object belongs to which person. For that, whose is used. So whose ke baad mein aapko koi na koi object aayega. So yahan par sentence diya hua hai, whose scrapbook is this. So that is the suitable option. In this way, you have to match these options with the correct question. And you have to complete this question. Next. Here, the pictures are given and you have to make questions suitable to this picture. First, that the action is mentioned. Someone is writing. So for the action, you can ask, what is he doing? Next is, the car is going, but where, that we don't know. So the question can be, where are you going? Next, the boy is reading. So the question can be, what are you reading? Now, in this jar, you can see there are some things, but we don't know. So the question can be asked that, what is in the jar? Next. Here you can see that both the girls are hugging each other, but why they are doing so, that we don't know. So the question will be, why are they hugging each other? Next, they are confused and they might not able to solve something. So the question can be, how can we solve this problem? Here the examples are given. You can write the sentence according to yourself also. Now, next, third question, in that answers are given and you have to form a question for these answers. So first one is, Kate was unwell yesterday. When? Yesterday. So the question will be, when was Kate unwell? Question mark. Okay. Next is, the road will remain closed for a week. So a time period aapko diya hai, to aap uske liye question bana sakte ho. How long will the road remain closed? How long, that is used to ask about the time duration. So duration is given of a week. Next is, Vanya is going to wait for us at the bus stop. A particular place is given. So for place, question can be asked about where. Now the question will be, where is Vanya going to wait for us? Just you have to remove the answer and rest of the sentence can be written as it is. In just to form the question, what you have to do, first you have to place WH question and then you have to place helping verb and then subject and remaining sentence will be written as it is. Just you have to remove the answer. So here the answer of where will be at the bus stop, that you have to remove and you have to write the sentence till us. Okay, in that after writing where, you have to put is before Vanya. So the sentence will be, where is Vanya going to wait for us? Question mark. Next is, mother helped me with my project work. So someone has helped, but who was that person? That can be the question. So here the question will be, who helped you with your project? Because the person will not ask the question to itself. So here the question is asked to you. That is why you have answered by yourself. Okay. So, jab bhi yahan par me, I, my diya ho, to question mein wo you ke liye hoga. Tabhi answer me se aayega. Okay. So, yahan par aapka question banega, who helped you with your project work? Question mark. Next is, I prefer playing outdoor to watching TV. सो यहाँ पर दो ऑप्शंस दिए हैं एंड आपको पूछा है कि आप कौन सा प्रिफर करेंगे. फॉर दैट यू कैन यूज़ द क्वेश्चन बिकॉज इट इज़ आस्क अबाउट थिंग. सो द क्वेश्चन कैन बी व्हाट डू यू प्रिफर प्लेइंग आउटडोर और वॉचिंग टीवी क्वेश्चन मार्क. नेक्स्ट इज आई एम अपसेट बिकॉज मदर स्कॉल्डेड मी. सो बिकॉज दैट मीन्स रीजन इज गिवन. सो यू हैव टू आस्क द रीजन इन द क्वेश्चन. फॉर आस्किंग द रीजन क्वेश्चन वर्ड वाई इज यूज एंड द क्वेश्चन विल बी वाई आर यू अपसेट. अगेन आई रिपीट वैन द आंसर इज गिवन बाई आई द क्वेश्चन विल बी आस्क्ड फॉर यू. ओके जब यू के लिए क्वेश्चन आता है तभी आई आंसर देगा. सो यहाँ पर क्वेश्चन में आई रिप्लेस हो जाएगा यू से एंड यू के अकॉर्डिंग हेल्पिंग वर्ब आ जाएगी आर. कीप इन माइंड दैट जब भी आपको इंट्रोगेटिव सेंटेंस दिया है हेल्पिंग वर्ब सब्जेक्ट से पहले आएगी. सो द सेंटेंस विल बी वाई आर यू अपसेट. ओके देन बिकॉज के बाद में आपको जो रीजन दिया है दैट यू हैव टू रिमूव. ओके एट द एंड यू हैव टू पुट क्वेश्चन मार्क. सो टू मेक द क्वेश्चन फ्रॉम द आंसर्स फर्स्ट थिंग दैट यू हैव टू डू दैट टू रिमूव द आंसर एंड सेकेंड थिंग place the helping verb before the subject. At the end of the sentence you have to put question mark and first letter should be capital. This is all what you have to do. So now here we have completed our exercise and I hope that this explanation would be useful for you and you might have got some idea about this topic. Here we have come to an end of this topic and then we will meet with new topic in new video. Till then take care of yourself. Be safe and keep on learning. Thanks for being with me. See you.